Hey butterflies, it's Leek. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Angelique, aka Leek, aka Head Butterfly. Today I'm doing this new makeup technique with my eyes and with my face. I usually do more like wispied out glam, but I tried to do like a rounded cut crease, and then my face was a total mess. You're probably gonna see it in the thumbnail. But I tried out a new technique. I feel like my face looks really good. But if you want to see how I got this lovely, lovely makeup look, my hair is bothering me, then just keep on watching the video. I'm so cheesy for this, but my TV is like always going to be there, so right now I'm going to have butterflies in the background because, period. I want to do a really vibrant pink cut crease. I'm going to list all the stuff that I use down below just because I want to focus on the look itself. But I'm basically just trying to, I'm going to lay out the color first. I'm definitely going to cut my crease somewhere up here. So you just want to like pat that color in really well, blend it out. I'm using a different pink because I just want to deepen it up a little bit. I want to try like a rounded cut crease because I always drag it out, so we're gonna see if I can do a rounded one. But you guys have seen me do a cut crease plenty of times. I'm just trying a different method. I'm gonna drag it out just a little bit more. I feel like it's pretty pink, but I wanted the crease to be a little bit darker. So I'm looking at the shades that I have, and I do have Dance Party in this Drunk Nail palette, which is like a little deeper, but I do want to be very careful with it. So I'm going to grab a brush and tap off a lot of the excess. I want to use the tiniest bit and put it right in the crease just to deepen it up even more. That's kind of how I want it to look. Yep. And I'm not even gonna like go over top of it and blend it out like I did the other colors. I just want it to be really deep in the look. So. And I actually will blend the edges just a little bit so it looks so harsh. Because once you cut it, it won't look as harsh. It also just looks harsh because it's all just there, but once I cut the crease, it won't look as harsh. I'm gonna try the trick where you do the cutting the crease with like micellar water or Vaseline, but I'm gonna use micellar water because I don't have any Vaseline, so. How well this works. But basically, like when you do, like I already primed my eyes, so if I go over it with primer again, it gets sort of like cakey. Which is why this is a trick now. A trick where you like cut your crease with this first. And then you let it dry. Alright, now I'm about to use the Anastasia primer and cut this crease. I think I'm definitely using the wrong brush, but it's applying nice. I think I'm gonna do like a white. I'm gonna pop this white over it. It looks pretty good. I'm gonna go over it. Like, I'm gonna definitely make this part look better, but the crease, it applies a lot better when you're not double, like, overdoing the primer part. But yeah, I need to go and fix it just a little bit, like on the edges. I'll bring it in some, and I might use like purple or something, so we'll see. I'm gonna use burgundy because purple might clash. I'm using this burgundy just to deepen up this outer part of my eye, because I want some dimension. I don't want it to all just be one like pink. I want it to be burgundy and all these other colors. So I'm gonna keep adding that burgundy till it looks the way I want it to. Alright, I'm really debating if I want to do a liner and really take it there, but I think I'm not. I think I'm just gonna do like a blue waterline and make it real like pop of color cute. So that's what I'm gonna do. Right now I'm gonna do my face. There's this technique I've been wanting to try that I see a couple people do. I don't have a stick foundation, but I'm gonna try to make this technique work. Basically, you put on concealer, contour, and foundation all at the same time. And then you blend it out with a brush to make it like real seamless. So let me get I need to do this strategically, so hold on. You're gonna put concealer everywhere you would put concealer. But actually I can use the applicator because she's actually using the applicator for the concealer. So you put concealer wherever you put concealer, right? I like to bring it down past my nose. I'm gonna do one more layer because I don't have foundation on underneath here like I normally do, and you know, no hot bowl in my bags. So the contour, and that's where you just put the contour wherever you would want to contour. Everywhere else you put your foundation with a little brush. I hope this comes out good. I'm about to spray my face. I really like it for the contour. I do. I can say that. The chin, I probably wouldn't do the chin again because I don't ever contour my chin. I just wanted to see what it would do, but it actually made my chin look a little dark, so. But for contour-wise, I actually really like it. It kind of skips the whole, well, for me, because I like to bake my contour to make sure it's sharp. It kind of skips that whole process, which is like, well, I do feel like it's drying down really fast though. And it has to be wet to really blend out well. And technically this is less makeup than I would normally wear, so. I'm leaving the part close to my eyes because I don't want to mess up my shadow, so. Just to be more precise around the eye area, because. Takes a lot of patience too. You would think this would make your makeup go a little quicker, and it does not. I think your face also needs to be really hydrated for this. I feel like your face needs to be super hydrated for this to work too. Like, not a trace of dryness, because I have a dry face. So the longer that this product is sitting, the drier it's basically getting. So I don't like the nose. I don't like that. I'll probably keep my nose technique the way it is, because I like the way I contour my nose right now. I'm not like 100% on how I feel just yet. I mean, it looks good, like in person and stuff too. Like, it looks good. I'm just like unsure about it. It just does something to the face that I don't know if I like it. Definitely need to do more contour next time, which I did notice that she went in really heavy with her contour. But I'm thinking like, oh, like, it's just, that's her preference. But no, like, you really need that extra, that like crazy amount for contour, so. So that is something that I would do differently too, is I don't want to lose that contour. I don't want to shine down, I don't want to shine cheeks. Alright, let me see, let me add the, add some more bronzer on my cheeks. It's aesthetically pleasing, but in terms of like being realistic, I don't feel like it's very realistic at all. These lashes were putting me through it. They still kind of are, but it's whatever. I don't know if I want to do the pop of color on the bottom or just keep it like soft, you know? If you want me to go more in depth about how I contour my lips, just go and watch my How to Catfish tutorial. I pretty much do the whole thing in that video. Alright, chickadees. So this is a completed look. It looks really cute. I feel really glam. It's been sitting in the house, but it's whatever. If you want to see more tutorials during this quarantine time, please let me know down below. Also, if you think that this makeup technique came out good, let me know, because I'm kind of not sure. It looks good on camera and like on my phone when I tried to take a selfie, but in person I'm like, I look kind of like, I don't know, I feel like there's not enough warmth in my face, and that's probably where I messed up, and that's my bad. But make sure you thumbs up this video, comment down below, and subscribe for some more leak in your life. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.